Minnesota Youth Soccer welcomes you to this short animated ride home from a soccer game. This offers parents some practical strategies to foster intrinsic motivation and a more positive soccer experience for their children. Right after the game, a statement of unconditional care and support, regardless of how the game went, can help children see that their worth in our eyes is not tied to their performance or the team's result. As parent chauffeurs, we have a captive audience in our children who are strapped into the back seat. Offering a two-way conversation gives them some choice in how and when to discuss the game. Children may request silence or want to talk about other things during this post-game period, and if we're honest, it may help to let our own excitement over the game fade a bit before discussing it. When we have the green light to talk about the game, asking open-ended questions allows children to steer the conversation toward topics they find important. If the response to an open-ended question is merely a grunt, try a more targeted question to ignite the conversation, like, "What was your favorite part of the game?" Similarly, when discussing individual or team performance, it's wise to ask for the child's viewpoint rather than delivering a monologue of our observations. This helps us to see the game through our children's eyes. And while the final score is one measure of team success, it can be a poor indicator of a player's effort and individual progress. When we recognize an individual achievement, even if we sometimes need them to point it out to us, it can be a boost to their motivation and desire going forward. It's easy to get detoured to a dead-end conversation about things that are out of players' control, like poor fields, controversial calls, or teammate mistakes. We might go down this road in an attempt to protect a child's self-esteem, but attributing a loss to these factors can backfire. Children may be less motivated to practice hard if they feel that outside forces have great power in determining results, as in, "Why should I work hard to improve if the ref is going to decide the game anyway?" When we keep the focus on what can be controlled, we help children to accept responsibility and to be resilient when confronted with those things they can't control. At home, we should help with any injuries or health concerns, including nutrition, hydration, and sleep for overall well-being and preparation for the next training or competition. As parents, we take on the important role of helping children to make sense of their soccer experience, and the post-game connections we make with them are important in that process. Ask your child, "How do you want the ride home to sound?" And if you have multiple players in your house, you may hear different answers that require you to adjust your strategies to best support each one. By meeting your children's needs in this way, you're creating an environment in which they are more likely to play longer, play better, and get the most enjoyment out of their soccer experience. Thanks for taking this ride.